So this course again, fish products and value addition. So we are in drying and dehydration, means drying chapter. So today we will cover drying process, then factor affecting the dehydration process, and factors that influence the rate of drying of fish, and phase or period of drying that we will cover. So as by the definition, we already know the drying. What is drying? What is drying? No one is reading my PowerPoint.
Refrigeration method है sir.
हाँ ठीक है, but how you can define? नहीं पता. I think nobody is reading. अरे your midterm is coming. You have to read. So drying is a method of preservation in which what we are doing, we are removing the moisture, we are removing the water. So if we are removing the moisture or water by natural process, then it is called as natural drying or drying. Or if we are means controlling to remove the water, controlling what? If we are controlling air velocity, relative humidity and temperature, these are the parameter. Because in natural drying we are not having a control because it is an open environment. So if we are removing the water in a controlled condition, then it is called as dehydration. So ultimately in both the process we are removing the water. So drying process basically involves two steps. The first step is the migration of water. If we are removing the water from the fish, or if we are doing a drying of fish, so what basically happen inside the fish body and how the drying takes place. So whatever the water molecules will be there inside the fish body, so that moisture or water will, there will be migration. So there will be movement of water molecules. So migration of water from the fish body to the point of vaporization zone or vaporization, where the vaporize means where the water will remove by the circulating air. Water which is inside the body, it is coming to the surface of the fish, and that surface layer is called as vaporization zone, where actual water will be evaporate. That's why this point is called as vaporization zone, surface of the fish body. So though, so this is called as diffusion. Diffusion means what? There will be movement of molecules from higher concentration to lower concentration. So if we are doing a drying and having an environment, so in the environment we are having a relative humidity. Humidity is there, some water vapor will be there. So that relative humidity should be low, then only the moisture transport or moisture or water movement will takes place, or evaporation takes place. So first process in drying is the migration of water from the fish body to the vaporization zone. Vaporization zone pe jab hamara water aa jayega, then it will be vaporized, it will be evaporated by the circulating air. जो ओपन एयर में जो हमारा एयर का मूवमेंट है, एयर का जो वेलोसिटी है, सो दैट एयर वेलोसिटी टेक द वॉटर वेपर एंड इट विल बी डिस्पर्स इन टू द सराउंडिंग एनवायरमेंट. सो दैट इज द इवोपोरेशन. सो बेसिकली टू स्टेप्स इन्वॉल्व, वन इज द डिफ्यूजन, अनदर वन इज द इवोपोरेशन. अंडरस्टूड? Drying process, if we are employing a drying of fish, so what actually happen inside drying process? So whatever the water molecules or moisture contents will be there, it will be migrated from inside the body of the fish to the surface of the fish. So that surface of the fish is the vaporization zone. And from here, the water will be evaporated by the circulating air. कोई तो means air velocity चाहिए ना वो water को लेकर के, means water vapor को लेकर के surrounding environment में disperse करें. So that's why the two process or two steps involved in drying process. First is the diffusion and second is the evaporation. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, the factor that influence the dehydration. What is dehydration?
So, आवाज नहीं आ रही है sir.
Mute हो गया.
Level of water molecule.
Control condition. In controlled condition.
We are removing the water in a controlled condition. That's why it is called as dehydration. So factor that influence the dehydration. So what are the factor? First factor is the equilibrium moisture content and the influence of humidity of surrounding environment. Second is the heat transfer and third is the mass transfer. So we will go one by one. Equilibrium moisture content and the influence of humidity. Actually, drying process mein hota kya hai? The pressure of water vapor at the surface of the fish is different from that of the water in the air. Jo surface of the fish or surface of the fish body ke upar mein jo water vapor hai, uska jo pressure hai. और जो सराउंडिंग एनवायरनमेंट में जो वाटर वेपर है उसका जो प्रेशर है, दोनों का देयर विल बी डिफरेंस, देन ओनली द वाटर वेपर विल बी ट्रांस, मींस देयर विल बी ट्रांसफर ऑफ वाटर वेपर फ्रॉम फिश टू सराउंडिंग एनवायरनमेंट और सराउंडिंग एनवायरनमेंट टू फिश. इट डिपेंड्स अपॉन द ग्रेडियंट वेयर इट इज हायर और लोअर. तो किधर से किधर मूवमेंट होगा, हायर टू लोअर और लोअर टू हायर?
हायर टू लोअर.
इट इज अ वाइस वर्सा. इट डिपेंड्स कौन सा एनवायरनमेंट में हायर है एंड कौन सा एनवायरनमेंट में लोअर है. तो जनरली फिश बॉडी के अंदर में जो वाटर है, जब हम उस पर टेम्परेचर अप्लाई करते हैं तो वाटर क्या होता है, धीरे 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 फिश के बॉडी पे आता है, सरफेस पे आता है एंड देन वो सरफेस पे आकर के वो इवोपरेट होता है. सो देयर विल बी सम प्रेशर. सो दैट प्रेशर विल बी वाटर वेपर प्रेशर एट द सरफेस ऑफ द फिश बॉडी एंड देयर विल बी ऑल्सो ए वेपर प्रेशर और वाटर वेपर प्रेशर ऑफ द सराउंडिंग एनवायरमेंट. Because of this pressure and this pressure difference, if it is created, then only there will be migration of water molecules from one medium to another medium. है ना? अगर fish के body के surface के ऊपर में water vapors higher है और surrounding environment में water vapor pressure lower है, तो किधर से किधर movement होगा water molecules का? हम बोल रहे हैं इफ वी आर अप्लाइंग ए ड्राइंग प्रोसेस, ठीक है, सो ड्राइंग प्रोसेस जब हम अप्लाई करते हैं तो फिश के बॉडी के अंदर का जो वाटर है वो वाटर माइग्रेट होकर के फिश के बॉडी के सरफेस पे आता है, सरफेस पे, दैट इज द पॉइंट, एंड दिस पॉइंट इज कॉल्ड एज वेपोराइजेशन जोन. सो यहां से वो वाटर क्या होता है, इवोपरेट हो जाता है. सो हियर सम प्रेशर विल क्रिएट, वाटर वेपर प्रेशर विल क्रिएट, देन ओनली द वाटर वेपर ट्रांसफर विल बी देयर और migration will be there or movement will be there from fish body surface to the surrounding environment. So fish body ka jo upar ka layer hai wahan pe jo vapor pressure hota hai that is the higher and surrounding environment mein hamara lower hona chahiye tabhi hamara water vapor ka transfer ho payega. But jab hamara fish dry ho jata hai, जब वो सूख जाता है तो वाटर वी हैव इवोपोरेटेड, देन देयर इज ए नो फ्री वाटर. सो इफ देयर इज ए नो फ्री वाटर दैट मींस देयर इज ए लोअर वाटर वेपर प्रेशर इनसाइड द फिश, ड्राइड फिश. अगर एनवायरमेंट में वाटर वेपर प्रेशर हायर होगा, ज्यादा हो जाएगा, देन अगेन देयर विल बी ए moisture transport mechanism
transfer
environment to fish may also come. So that is called as process of sorption. Sorption means uptake of water, and desorption means release of water. So this sorption and desorption generally why it is occurring, because of the pressure differences of water vapor at the surface of the fish to the surrounding medium or surrounding environment or surrounding environment to this surface of the fish. So this process will be continue. ऐसा तो नहीं है पानी लेते ही रहेगा, वाटर वेपर लेते ही रहेगा. कभी जाके तो पॉइंट आएगा जहां पे सैचुरेट हो जाएगा. तो जहां पे वो सैचुरेट हो जाएगा, सो दैट पॉइंट इज कॉल्ड एज इक्विलिब्रियम मॉइस्चर कॉन्टेक्ट. प्रोसेस ऑफ सॉर्प्शन और डिसॉर्प्शन विल कंटिन्यू अंटिल द प्रेशर ऑफ वाटर वेपर एट द फिश सरफेस एंड इन द एयर इज इक्वलाइज. सो दिस पॉइंट इज कॉल्ड एज इक्विलिब्रियम मॉइस्चर कॉन्टेक्ट. सराउंडिंग एनवायरमेंट में जो हमारा वाटर वेपर प्रेशर है और हमारा प्रोडक्ट जो फिश हम ड्राई कर रहे हैं उसके बॉडी के अंदर का जो एनवायरमेंट है उसका जो है वाटर वेपर प्रेशर, दोनों इक्विलिब्रिएट हो जाएगा. देन देयर विल बी नो माइग्रेशन, देयर विल बी नो मूवमेंट, देयर विल बी नो ट्रांसफर. सो दिस पॉइंट इज कॉल्ड एज इक्विलिब्रियम मॉइस्चर कॉन्टेंट. अंडरस्टूड? हेलो
यस सर,
इम्पोर्टेंट सी, एंड बेसिकली व्हाई दिस फैक्टर इज इम्पोर्टेंट, बिकॉज इट मेनली डिपेंड्स अपॉन द ह्यूमिडिटी इन एनवायरमेंट. व्हाट इन ह्यूमिडिटी इज देयर, बेस्ड ऑन दैट द वाटर वेपर ट्रांसपोर्ट मैकेनिज्म टेक्स प्लेस. So in control condition, we can control this parameter. We can control this parameter because dehydration process, now we are having an enclosed environment. We are having a machine. So in machine, we can feed. Agar jyada humidity ho jata hai, to we have to dehumidify. We have to dehumidify. So we will reduce the relative humidity. Then there will be transfer or transport of this water vapor from surface of the fish body to the surrounding environment. So this is one factor. Then there is a heat transfer. As we know, the drying, why, how drying takes place? We are removing the water, but how? we are drawing a face. So in that process, how the removal of water takes place? बताओ यार, पानी अपने आप तो नहीं निकल जाएगा ना. वी हैव टू गिव समथिंग, वी हैव टू फीड समथिंग, वी हैव टू कंट्रोल समथिंग. व्हाट? ड्राइंग ऑफ फिश जनरली इन्वॉल्व्स व्हाट?
Light, natural light.
Okay, agree. On, anyone?
Or heat, sir. Heat.
We are applying a heat. Shrikant, here we are discussing about the dehydration. Okay, so whenever dehydration, generally term ऐसा नहीं है, restriction नहीं है, जो जहाँ dehydration है वहाँ drying नहीं कर सकते हैं. बट ओवरऑल देखा जाए, डिहाइड्रेशन मीन्स बोलते हैं कंट्रोल्ड एनवायरनमेंट में अगर हम कोई भी वाटर को रिलीज करते हैं प्रोडक्ट से, देन वी आर किलिंग डिहाइड्रेशन. बट यू वी कैन यूज ड्राइंग और डिहाइड्रेशन बोथ, देयर इज नो रिस्ट्रिक्शन. सो श्रीकांत इज टिलिंग, वी आर यूजिंग अ लाइट. लाइट इज ऑल्सो ए फॉर्म ऑफ एनर्जी, सनलाइट वी आर यूजिंग. हम नेचुरल ड्राइंग करते हैं तो सनलाइट वी आर यूजिंग. बट नेचुरल में हम सनलाइट करते हैं, बट जब हम कंट्रोल्ड एनवायरनमेंट में हम करते हैं तो देन वी आर यूजिंग ए हीट. बोथ, एक में लाइट हो रहा है, दूसरा में हीट हो रहा है, बट बोथ आर द फॉर्म ऑफ एनर्जी. सो ड्राइंग ऑफिस दैट इन्वॉल्व्स द रिमूवल ऑफ वॉटर, एज ऑलरेडी वी नो, इट इज ए फेनोमेना in which water will remove from the fish body by the application of heat energy or with the input of thermal energy. We have to apply a heat. To heat apply karenge to fish ke body ke andar mein jo water rahega, wo water kahan pe aayega? Fish ke body ke surface pe aayega. Point of vaporization, yahan se water kya ho jayega? Evaporate ho jayega. So there is a outward flow of water vapor. That means inside the fish body, water is coming out. That's why it is outward flow of water vapor. And at the same time, there is an inward flow of heat energy. Inward flow of heat energy. Heat energy penetrate kar raha hai, water bahar aa raha hai. Then drying is linked with the rate of supply of heat to the point of evaporation occurs. And its conduction within the materials. Hota kya hai? If we are supplying a heat, if we are supplying a heat, if it is enclosed environment or open environment, if we are applying a heat, so it must reach to the point of evaporation, that is the surface of the fish body. Here the heat reaches, but ultimately where it has to go? It has to penetrate inside the fish body. So how the heat transfer mechanism is takes place? यहां से तो आ गया radiation, light energy अगर हम use कर radiation, and from here point of evaporation the heat transfer mechanism takes place by conduction process. So one molecules, जो water molecules surface पे होंगे, that will be heated, and this water molecules will ट्रांसफर द हीट टू द नेबरिंग, जो आस पड़ोस की जो वाटर मॉलिक्यूल्स होंगे वो उसको क्या करेंगे, हीट प्रोवाइड करेंगे. सो देर इज ए कॉन्टैक्ट, दैट्स वाई कंडक्शन, देर इज ए कॉन्टैक्ट, हैंड टू हैंड कॉन्टैक्ट. सो देर इज ए सप्लाई ऑफ हीट. अंडरस्टूड? हेलो, हेलो, अंडरस्टूड? ये प्रोसेस हीट ट्रांसफर, हीट ट्रांसफर कैसा होता है? ओपन एनवायरनमेंट है, रेडिएशन से आया, आकर के फिश के बॉडी के सरफेस, दैट इज द पॉइंट ऑफ इवोपरेशन. हियर विल touch or heat, the surface will be heated and from here inside the body fish ke jana chahiye, tabhi to andar ka jo pani hai wo bahar nikal ke aayega. So from the surface of the fish to the inside the fish body, the heat transfer is takes place by conduction process. But how heat will transfer? Heat will transfer first water present on the surface of the fish body or at the point of evaporation, it will be heated and this water molecules will transfer the heat to the neighboring water molecules. And ultimately it reaches to the center of the fish. Then slowly, slowly water will comes out and it will comes to the surface of the fish body. And here again, evaporation takes place. So this is the heat transfer mechanism. Understood? Yes, no, kuch bolo.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, aage chalte hain. Then there is a mass transfer. Heat transfer, equilibrium moisture content, then mass transfer. Drying already kitna bad bol bol ke ye means definition yaad ho gaya hoga. Drying generally it is a process of removal of water. So there is a migration of water within the body to the surface. There is a migration of water within the body of the fish to the surface, and from here again there is a removal of water. So this water will be evaporated to the surrounding medium or surrounding atmosphere. So the factor controlling the rate of transfer of water from the moist body to its surrounding, that means rate, that means speed at which the water which is present inside the fish body will comes from inside the fish body to the surface of the fish is influenced by the physical characteristics of the body environment. That means physical characteristics fish ka body ka, fish ke body ka, aur jo bhi material hum dry kar rahe hain uska jo environment hai us pe depend karta hai rate of transfer of water from the moist body to the surrounding medium. So what are the physical characteristics of body environment? First is the temperature, then pressure, then relative humidity and air velocity. These are the physical characteristics of the body environment. Temperature, pressure, relative humidity and air velocity, all these four parameters that affects the rate of transfer of water from the moist body of the fish to the surface. Temperature badhega to faster removal hamara hoga. Again pressure difference higher to lower or lower to higher, vice versa, it depends. Relative humidity it should be low, then only there will be moisture or water movement will takes place. Air velocity agar hum high karenge then jaldi se evaporation hoga. So this is the mass transfer. Mass in terms of jo water hum machli ke sharir ke andar se la kar ke surface tak pahunchate hain aur wahan se fir wo evaporate ho jata hai. So basically inside the fish body to the surface and then there will be evaporation. So this factor or the rate of transfer of water from moist body to the surrounding is basically determined by the physical characteristics of the body environment. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Then process is there. What are the modes of mass transfer? Machli itna bada hai, koi chota machli hota hai, koi bada machli hota hai, to koi jaldi sukh jata hai, koi bahut din tak bahut samay lagta hai agar natural environment mein kar rahe hain. But how this water is coming from inside the fish body to the surface? So there is a modes of mass transfer. First is the liquid movement under capillary force. There will be capillary. छोटे जैसे वेन है ना हमारा वेन बॉडी के अंदर में. So there एक रास्ता बनेगा capillary force. From that capillary force, the water movement will means water will come from inside the fish body to the surface of the fish. Then there is a liquid diffusion due to the concentration gradient. Diffusion already told. Higher to lower, then vapor diffusion due to the partial pressure gradient. Again, this is higher at the point of evaporation, pressure difference. Then surface diffusion in liquid layer absorbed at the solid interface. So solid interface, that is the surface of the fish body. So inside the fish body, water is coming and it is attached on the solid interface or the surface of the fish body. And from here again, this evaporation takes place. Then water flow caused by shrinkage and pressure gradient. Then flow caused by gravity, pressure. Then flow caused by vaporization, condensation sequences. So these are the some mode. But first four mode is the most important. And most of the means product it occurs. Liquid movement, liquid diffusion, vapor diffusion, and surface diffusion. One is capillary force, another is concentration gradient, another one is partial pressure gradient, and then the liquid means surface diffusion in liquid layer absorbed at surface of the fish or solid interface. Then, so that is the factor which influencing the dehydration, equilibrium moisture content and relative humidity. My heat transfer, mass transfer. Now, factor that influence the drying rate of fish. So, this drying rate of fish is affected by several factors, having both intrinsic as well as the extrinsic. Intrinsic, what is intrinsic factor? Intrinsic. What do you mean by intrinsic? Intrinsic factor. बोलो बोलो आई थिंक हमने ये पढ़ाया है इंट्रिंसिक कोई नहीं बोल रहा है यार नोबडी इज रीडिंग घर में पढ़ते नहीं हो इंट्रिंसिक फैक्टर और पैरामीटर और नेचर is the parameter which is inherent to the fish. Which is inherent to the fish. Say for example, species, you can't change. Biochemical composition, you can't change. Then sex, you can't change. So that is inherent. We are not having a control. That is inherent to the fish. An external factor or means extrinsic factor or extrinsic parameter, those parameter of the surrounding environment. So here we are talking about the drying. So surrounding environment is what? What parameter we have to control? We have to control air velocity, relative humidity, temperature. These three parameters. So that is the extrinsic parameter or extrinsic factor. Intrinsic factor that influences the drying rate, that means the speed of drying. How it influences? Suppose biochemical parameter, lean fish is there and fatty fish is there. Some fish is having a more amount of water. So that fish will dry faster because more water present in the fish. So water will evaporate easily. Then another one is कोई बड़ा fish है, कोई छोटा fish है. So it is the surface area. If we are increasing more surface area, so there will be again faster drying. अगर surface area कम होगा, say for example bigger fish, whole fish, if we are drying, so surface area is lesser, so there will be a slower rate of drying. Then extrinsic factor, this relative humidity of the air. If the relative humidity is higher in the surrounding environment, then again there will be a slower rate of drying. If the relative humidity is lower in the surrounding environment, then again there will be a faster rate of drying, vice versa. Then air temperature. If we are increasing the temperature, we can increase the rate of drying. If we are decreasing the rate temperature, we can decrease the rate of drying. It's also vice versa. Air velocity. If we are increasing the air velocity, it will take more amount of water vapor from the point of evaporation. So there will be a faster rate of drying. But that is not recommended. Higher temperature also not recommended, and higher air velocity is also not recommended. For temperate countries, the temperature which is recommended for drying is the 25 to 35 degrees Celsius, and for tropical fishes or tropical countries fishes, the drying temperature recommended is the 40 to 50 degrees. That is the range in which we have is dry. Then the air velocity inside the dryer, there should be 75 to 130 meter per minute. जो fan का speed है और air का speed है, it should be 75 to 130 meter per minute. So all these three parameter in drying is most important. Dry, relative humidity, air temperature, and air velocity. And it should be controlled and monitored carefully if we are doing a if we are using a mechanical drying or natural drying also. Natural drying we don't have a control, so it is we are depending on the God. अरे God जो दे देगा हो जाएगा, है ना? तो but in dryer, mechanical dryer, we can control. So that's why we have to carefully monitor air velocity, relative humidity, and temperature. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Wait, I think this time is very less. I will end the session. Again, you have to join. Okay. Last is phase drying or period of drying is there. I will cover. You all have to join again. Rejoin.
Okay, sir.
Okay, sir.